In this video I'm going to arm you with a bunch of Slitherlink patterns. Numbers in corners. When you have a 1 in a corner, we can place X's here. You can't have lines on the puzzle edges, because they will not be able to escape from the corner. Both sides in the corner must be X. If we have a 2 in a corner, then there are lines here. The solution of a Slitherlink puzzle is a closed loop with no crossings or branches. It is easy to deduce that any dot in the lattice has either 0 or 2 lines connected to it. This also applies to the dot in the corner. It can have 0 lines connected to it, which results in this. Or you can have 2 lines connected to it, which results in this. In both cases there are 2 lines which are always there. 3 in a corner results in this. Again we can focus on the corner dot. If there are no lines connected to it, then the 3 cannot be solved. So the dot has 2 lines connected to it. Patterns with 1s. If we have 2 1s diagonally and there are X's like this, then we also have X's here. We can't have a line here, nor here. Those sides should be X's. If we have X's like this, then we also have X's here. There is a line either here, or here. Because otherwise we should have X's. And the 1 will be wrong. We should place X's here. In a situation like this, we can place X's here. This is because the line will continue in one of these directions and it will complete the 1. In a similar scenario we can place a line here. That is because otherwise, if we place an X, we cannot complete the 1. And the third variation is this. We can place an X here, because if the line continues downwards, we will not be able to complete the 1. Patterns with 2s. The most common pattern with 2s is when we have a corner segment pointing towards a 2 like this. This creates a chain reaction for as many 2s as we have on that diagonal. The next pattern with a 2 is this one. Let's see the logic behind it. We cannot continue the line downwards, because we will not be able to complete the 2. We place an X there. We cannot place the 2 lines around the 2 like this. So the other side of the 2 must be a line. The next patterns is when there is a 2 and a 0 on the edge of the puzzle. We can't have a line here so it is an X. The rest is trivial. Similar to the 2 in the corner, in this case we can have the lines placed like this, or like this. The next pattern is a consequence of the previous one. It is valid with any number of 2s placed diagonally. If we place an X here then there are 2 options. The first one leads to a crossing. The second one leads to a dead end. This means that it must be a line there. A consequence of this pattern is that when we have a 1 on the other side of the diagonal, its far end sides should be X's. Patterns with a 3. When there is a line going into a 3. It results into this. If the X on the 3 is somewhere on the far end, this will cause a crossing. Those 2 must be lines. And if our line continues downwards, we can't solve the 3. This can also be extended with any number of 2s on the diagonal. When we have 2 3s diagonally next to each other, we can place lines on their far end sides. If one of these sides is an X, it will cause a contradiction to the other 3. Same applies if we have 1 or more 2s between the 3s. If we have 2 or more 3s next to each other, then we can apply the next pattern. The first 3 cannot be oriented like this, because it will form a small loop. It also cannot be like this, because the next 3 couldn't be solved. We are left with two options. It will either face this way or this way. As you can see, two or more threes next to each other are causing an S-shaped segment. We don't know its orientation, but some of the lines are always there. Obviously, if we have a 2 somewhere next to a middle 3, we can solve the entire segment. When the 2 is next to a 3, which is at the end, we can place a line above it. The 3s can be solved like this or like this. But in both cases there is a line above the 2. The next pattern is a very common one. We mark the sides of the 0 with an X, which leaves only 3 available sides for the 3. The next pattern is also very common. We place X's around the 0. For this dot we can either have 0 or 2 lines. If there are 0, then the 3 cannot be solved. So they must be 2. The next pattern is when we have a 1 and a 3 diagonally, and the 3 has lines on its far end sides. We can place X's here because otherwise we wouldn't be able to solve the 3. The opposite is also true. When we have X's like this on the 1, then the far end sides of the 3 must be lines. This is because one of these two will be a line, forming the pattern with a line going into a 3. The next pattern is only with X's. When they are positioned like this, we can place one more X to form a cross. A line in that place would have nowhere to continue. Advanced techniques. Closed regions. When there is a region from which the lines cannot escape, it must have an even number of ends. In this case, if we solve the one like this, then this will leave only 3 ends in the closed regions. The line must enter the region to make the number of ends even. Unique solution technique. All quality Slitherlink puzzles have only one solution. We can use this fact in our favor. In this example, if we solve the 2s like this, then the other 2 can be solved in 2 valid ways. This would mean that the puzzle has more than one solution, so we can rule it out. We can solve the example like this. This helps us to find the next pattern. When we have a 2 in the corner and the cells next to it are empty, see the small dots, then we can place these lines. Something that we can use in exceptionally difficult puzzles is that a line crosses a closed curve even number of times. This means that on each row we have an even number of vertical lines. And on each column we have an even number of horizontal lines. And one general advice. Never make a guess. Play only moves that you are 100% certain they are correct. Congratulations for making it this far. In the next video I will show you how to make the most of the interface of puzzle-loop.com. I will show you all the settings, different modes and helpers. How to play on a desktop computer or on a mobile device. With a mouse, keyboard or a touchscreen.